While you can enable two-factor authentication, those codes are generated every 30 seconds can be tedious. While it's good for your account, they are annoying. That's where the YubiKey comes in. It aims to make that process easier and less of a hassle for you. The good folks over at Yubico sent us their new YubiKey Neo Senior CES 2015, as well as their older YubiKey Fido to review. Both feature a little gold button on the top, which you tap to enter in a randomly generated 48-digit PIN as your second password into your account. However, that's only for a select few accounts right now. We'll touch a little more on that later. The YubiKey Fido is a very simple product as compared to the Neo. It pretty much does one thing and one thing only: Google. All the Fido runs is UF2 or Universal Second Factor Authentication. That's a protocol that Google uses to allow you to use a little key like this to access your account. Unlike the Neo and the standard YubiKey, there is no support for other accounts or passwords. We'll talk about Google integration a little later as well. Now onto the Neo. This is YubiKey's top-of-the-line device. Some of the top features is Google support, NFC, and all other account password support. YubiKey makes a regular model as well, however that doesn't support NFC or Google. To me, NFC is worth the extra $25 alone. YubiKey also sells the Neo in standard and smaller models if you'd rather go for those. Before we get into the YubiKey, first I need to warn you about how complex it is. The YubiKey Neo runs three different protocols that allow you to use second factor authentication. You need to know what you're doing or at least be a little familiar with these. It's difficult to set up without any knowledge of which protocol your account uses. With that said, let's get on to the setup. YubiKey makes applications for OS X, Windows, and Linux that allow you to enable and disable certain protocols, as well as change the name. For Google, you just need to enable two-factor authentication within your account settings, select security key, plug in your device, tap the button, and Google is enabled on your YubiKey. However, with our testing, it only asked me for my key when I got auto-logged out of a page that I was previously signed into. It never asked for the YubiKey when I was logging in for the first time on a computer, rather for a code from the Authenticator app on my phone. When it does ask for it, I just have to tap the button and I'm signed in. You first have to enter in your username and regular password, however. Other than Google and a select few sites like WordPress, there isn't many sites that support the touch to login feature. If you want to use the YubiKey like an Authenticator app, then you first have to download the YubiKey Authenticator app for desktop or Android. However, I had enabled the CCID protocol first before Authenticator app would recognize it. Mine was shipped with the OTP and UF2 connection type pre-enabled, but the CCID one wasn't. After that, you just need to enter in your code generated by the two-factor authentication site, and then it will automatically generate the 6-digit security codes every 30 seconds, like the app on your phone. However, when you are asked for the PIN, you can't tap the button on the device. Rather, you have to open the Authenticator app and look at the code from there. Unless you have an Android phone with NFC, you're out of luck seeing those codes on an admin-protected computer. NFC works great and is much easier than adding second-factor authentication codes from a computer. While using the device on computers, I did encounter some problems. At times, the light on the side would go from solid to slowly flashing to fast flashing. When I tapped the button on the side when it was flashing, it wouldn't enter any codes, and at times the computer wouldn't even recognize the device. Then you were really out of luck for those 6-digit codes without an Android device. Overall, these are great to have around if you're all about two-factor authentication. If you are a heavy user of services that support the touch to login feature, this is definitely worth it. However, with the lacking ability to touch to enter those 6 digits generated by all the sites that support second factor authentication, this just seems like an Authenticator app on a USB drive. Furthermore, you also have to have the Authenticator app on your computer or phone. Also, the problems with the computer losing the connection seems like a problem to me. These devices are more targeted at companies who would like to deploy them to their employees or prosumers, or people who really know what they're getting into. They also support a wide variety of other things, more than just logins like we showed here. Depending on how you want to use it, you could have a different experience. But if you want to use it as a portable authenticator, then it just comes down to either plugging this into your computer or pouring out your phone to enter in a code. After use for some time, we can confidently give the YubiKey Fido 3 stars because of the limited functionality of the device, but the easy Google integration. We would rate the YubiKey Neo 3.5 stars because it works great for those few accounts, but requires too much software and not enough automation for normal 6-digit second factor authentication sites. If you'd like to learn more about the Fido, you can pick one up with that link in the description for only $18. You can also pick the Neo for $50. But that was our review on the YubiKey Fido and Neo. Let me know what you think about them down in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching. This is Mark with iAppleTech1Intuit.